This is the Italian Book Club from Rome and London, meeting today at the Frankfurt Book Fair with Raja Alem. Raja, thank you for joining us.
Thank you. It's very amazing to hear that Italian book club in
Yeah, London and Rome, and we're here in Frankfurt. And
meeting a Saudi
from Mecca, you tell me?
Exactly, yeah. I'm originally from Mecca. I was born in Mecca in a very conservative family. Mm-hmm. You know, in Mecca, Mecca is raised about receiving the strangers because it's believed to be God's home. So people come from everywhere to be just neighbor to God. So the elite families in Mecca, which are the sons of the judges, they are dedicated to receive the strangers. For example, the house of my grandfather was of 7 floors. Usually the ground floor is dedicated to receive strangers who doesn't have the means to live. So we host them. Mm-hmm. Then during the pilgrimage time, we empty, for example, the house, 7 floors. We live, for example, uncles, aunts, all the families. You find maybe 15 families living in the house. During the Hajj time, the pilgrimage time, we evacuate all those floors and live on the roof. You find, for example, 10 families living on the roof, and the full house is full of strangers, of pilgrims. You find Indians, Turkish, Egyptian. So the whole world coming into our house. It's like a cosmopolitan cocoon full of the world cultures, fashions, cuisines, languages. So for me, it's very, very rich. And when you look from the roof, in the roof, it's like a feast. Women singing and entertaining, receiving those pilgrimage. They bring with their gifts. So when we look from the roofs to the street, Mecca is small and the streets are very narrow. So you feel, see those thousands of people, heads, thousands, like a river running. So this is what obsessed me, this river of human beings, regardless of their religions, of their languages, of their races. So I'm trying to capture that in my book. So when you go into my book, you ask me about the story of my book. There is no real story. It's like the city of Mecca is possessing me. And it's talking through me. Really, when I write, touch the keyboard of my computer, I feel as if I'm plugged to some cosmopolitan library. And there are sounds channeled through me.
Yes.
And I write in a kind of trance. When I surface, I'm astonished. Who wrote this? So I hear Mecca talking to me, trying to convey this river. So now when I come here in Frankfurt Book Fair and see this 300,000 today in the book fair, this is the river I'm talking about. So in my book, I don't talk about one story. I talk, for example, now we are standing, you and me. Look inside your head. What is inside your head? Inside your head, what you browsed this morning, the emails you received, the Instagram photos you watched, the sounds of the people around you. This is what I'm trying to capture in my book. Moments. For me, a moment is like a home. You go in this house, small home, and you discover, you touch every wall. You pop up out from every window. You bang every door. I want to discover. And this I convey in my book.
It sounds poetical to me.
Yeah, it is poetical. It's like a flow of energy.
Right.
Yeah, because for me, writing or talking to you now, you have this positive energy. So I feel my energy is flowing. So in my book, you find this stream, a strong current, which is shocking because the reader at the beginning, they cannot enter this. They feel the shock, so they get frightened. Then when they get into the stream, they are swept away. They cannot get out of it. I remember once in Poland, when my book was translated to Polish, this was a very famous critic, and he told me, Raja, I started reading your book. I didn't put it for drinking a water, even for drinking a water. So it's like that. It's moment after moment after moment, like when you go in a street and you just drift, see this gallery, see this building. It's like that. It's wandering in life, in my life, because this book is my life. You know, I look at myself as a creature of multiple personality. The personality which lived in Mecca, which is very, very conservative, where you wear this black and you are not exposed to the world. and this richness, ritual richness, where in dawn you feel this, you wake up at the sound of the call for prayer. For me, it's not a call for prayer, it's a call for, because when you call for prayer, they say, Hayya ala salah. Hayya, it means come alive, come alive. So for me, it's a call to come alive to life. So when you wake up and hear this, come alive, come alive, in, from everywhere, like a net of music. So they, so that, that's why now I wonder why people are talking about Islam or like that. It's not Islam, because calling that Islam, Christianity, Judaism, Buddhism, it's only frames to create blockage between people. The essential thing is faith, is the energy. This current now running between we and you and all those people who are from different nationalities.
And you, it's so important at this time in the world that Mecca has a voice and is represented out in the world in a way that can be received by the world who doesn't know it. Obviously as a woman you get to have a very particular position given what you described there in gender relations there. When was the book published, and how has your position as a woman in society changed over the time of that?
My position didn't change because since I started I was a creature outside of any country. When you say you're a woman, Saudi writer, I'm shocked. I don't belong to anybody. I belong to any country. I belong to the books I read, to the frame of thinking, this free flow of thinking, of energy. For example, when I published it, it was in 2010. It came out at the end of June, month of June. And it was last day to apply for the Booker Prize, Arabic Booker, International Arabic Prize for Fiction. And my publisher called me. I recall I was in Paris. I was not thinking of the book. And he said, Raja, I want to submit your book to the Booker Prize, Arabic Booker. I was not enthusiastic because for me, I don't like competitions. But for me, I said, why not? Maybe it will help the publisher sell the book. So why not? I said, why not? So, but I knew when he submitted, it was the last day to submit a book. I knew when he submitted that I will get the prize because my writing in the Arab world, it is cool in itself. It brings something which is human, international, global. It's like universal. And it happened that I won the Booker Prize 2011.
And well done.
I want it. And what it gave you, this... being a writer. Today I will give the prize of Liberator. And Liberator is a very prestigious prize given by the readers. So when it was translated into German, the reader chose it as the best book translated into German literature.
Fantastic.
So for me, this is what life is about, that you do what you can do, the best you can do. Every day I wake up and like breathing, I write. For me, writing is an act of breathing. It's my yoga. And I never looked back. I never thought of censorship or who will read the book, who will approve it, who will not. And I just write and publish and move ahead, flow ahead. And things happen.
Yeah, the flow of life takes it. And I feel your heart for your message, for your city. I look forward greatly to reading an English translation.
Spring. It will come in April, and from Overlook, it will come in English.
Yeah, because as we come back to that message being so important, but not only that, but you and your enthusiasm for it, your ease, your encouragement of flow is a model for other people. So thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. It's a pleasure talking to you because you have this flow. I feel it. This your organization has this flow because you flow in the everywhere and you just pick beautiful things for people to just look up at.
Well, thank you. It's part of the Italian nature, the Italian book club in Rome and London, to have some flow, you understand. Congratulations again. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Thank you, Web.